A critical goal in logic scaling is to pack more transistors into the same amount of space. And doing that is anything but simple. We'll take you through the transistor architectures that have enabled logic scaling, and what is in store for the future. In this edition of Semi 101. Field-effect transistors, or FETs, are one of the building blocks of semiconductors. FET devices have three terminals: source, gate, and drain, which are all part of the transistor. They were called planar because the body of the transistor was flat, and the gate only acted on the top side. But as transistors got smaller, in this architecture, electrical current began to leak between the source and drain. So the industry moved to a new design, called FinFET. In this design, the body of the transistor is raised above the silicon surface to form a vertical fin. The gate is now able to act upon three sides of the channel instead of just one, resulting in better management of current flow and much lower leakage. But as microchip designs continued to shrink, it became increasingly difficult to control leakage of current in this architecture as well. Enter Gate-All-Around. Here, the gate surrounds the channel on all four sides, which allows even tighter control of the current, again reducing leakage. The other advantage for Gate-All-Around is it offers a pathway for continued area scaling in the future. But as we all know, the desire for faster and more powerful chips continues, which means scaling does too. To continue to pack more transistors into a chip, the roadmap calls for a new architecture, known as CFET. With this approach, chip makers will vertically stack one polarity on top of the other. This architecture creates a complementary pair of devices in the footprint of a single gate-all-around device, allowing for continued area scaling. Lam's etch and dep product innovations are enabling foundry logic evolution from FinFET to gate-all-around and beyond. This was Semi 101.